Welcome back to Let's Play Life is Strange Before the Storm. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, here with the final bonus episode. Farewell. Featuring Mac Caulfield again. Max. For some reason I did not enunciate that. Anyway. I'm just curious if this thing's working. Okay. Just making sure. I have a device called a tactical board, which I use in lieu of a keyboard and, you know, for gaming purposes. And sometimes it likes to basically uninstall itself. That makes any sense? Start episode. I'm excited. I wonder if it's going to be as long as the other episodes. We'll find out. So I'm slowly finishing up all this episodic content. Is that like a Barbie doll or something? Mannequin? Okay, they're like Barbie dolls. They're gonna blow up Barbie dolls. Oh my. In the room?
Ready, I guess.
Is that the M80?
But isn't your mom gonna freak? She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing.
Right. Sure
I
she won't.
She'll notice a hole in the floor. Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
They're so young. They're like barely recognizable to me. Is that an M80 or something else? It looks like it. It's a dud. Nope. Nope, it wasn't.
Tell me that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen!
That was amazing.
That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome? That's like asking, why are puppies cute? Some things just are. I'm not sure your mom would see it that way. When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning, too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
We can't explode it? So Max is really worried about what Chloe's mother would think.
It feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over now.
Well, you'll have one less hurrah.
In a few days, my whole family moves to Seattle. I have no idea when I'll see Chloe again. This could be my last chance to say goodbye.
And then she doesn't even keep in touch. I mean,
but how do you tell your best friend that you're leaving her?
Oh, she doesn't know. Chloe doesn't know. Yet. As far as I know, guys, you could only get this episode with the deluxe edition. So I made sure to do that.
I better help Chloe with her cleaning. And while I'm at it, I can take one long last look around this place.
We will do so.
Live fast, die young, and go out with a bang. Rest in peace. Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour.
Comic strip.
Chloe's had this hung up on her wall forever, but neither of us can figure out what happened to the last panel. I hope Dr. Kloenstein's okay.
She doesn't remember. The Adventures of Supermax and Dr. Kloenstein. Are crime fighting has really soared since you created these rocket boosters. Get it? A Of course, the power of flight does tend to make things easier. Dr. Klonstein? I do love this poster. It's freaking awesome.
Chloe's always preferred imaginary animals to real ones. Well, besides Bongo, of course.
Bongo?
This was our first unsupervised concert together. It was so much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month, but...
How sick was that show?
The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one. Check it out. How about you? Any new moves?
Totally.
Yeah, totally. I've been working on my air guitar.
Damn, bow, Caulfield. Bow, save something bow. For when it counts. All right, back to the junk mines.
The junk mines. All right, what else we got? A board game. Oh, look or trash. Okay.
Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever.
Oopsies.
And I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces.
Reminds me of the game, sorry. Gonna put it in the trash. It's like Chloe's movie.
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
We never play.
Chloe, we haven't played this game in years. And it's missing half the pieces.
Nice try, Max. But you can't erase your shame that easily.
Nice try. Do you have anything else to say?
I can see why Chloe has such a hard time cleaning out her room.
What is this thing? Chloe Bear?
Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you, oh almighty Chloe Bear.
Nah.
As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still kick her butt in PE, though.
So pretty good grades.
That was awesome. Who else but Chloe could turn cleaning her room into a pyrotechnical adventure?
Go sleepy? Not yet.
Hey, what's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Is sure. This? Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes.
Is this where it starts? Chloe's photo.
You're off to a great start.
Taking interest?
Actually, it's kind of cool.
That it is. What you got in here? Menagerie of Magic.
I was lucky to survive Chloe's magic phase with all my fingers intact.
She's not gonna let you throw this out.
This seems like a good candidate. Are you insane? That's my entire magic collection. Do you know how many weeks of allowance this cost?
You never use it.
You haven't touched these since the 5th grade talent show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of fake blood.
Oops.
At least you didn't saw me in half.
How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything?
Hmm. A magician never reveals her secrets. Put it back.
Let's see, we've got the periodic table. Look at it again.
I guess Chloe wants to keep the magic alive.
I can't look at the periodic table. Acceptance letter. Oh.
I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out when she got this letter.
To the parents of Chloe Price. Dear parents, congratulations. Your child, Chloe Price, has been accepted for September 2008 admission to Blackwell Academy. We have offered places to approximately 100 students out of 1,200 applicants. Your child excelled in all criteria for admission. I bet she ended up getting kicked out, as we saw in the previous episodes. An open house for admitted students and parents will be held on March 26th. April 2nd is the deadline to inform us of your intentions regarding admission. Your admission reply form is included. For those who require financial aid, please contact Blackwell's Office of Financial Assistance. We look forward to welcoming you and Chloe to the Blackwell Academy family. Sincerely, Marco S. Gonzalez, Director of Admissions. Oh, that was exciting to read.
I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
Nah. Push further. They're not fine, are they?
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings. Is everything okay?
I don't know. I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks. I guess.
You know what I mean. I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks.
Yay, I'm real. Does she say anything a second time to say?
I hear Blackwell students aren't the easiest to get along with. I hope Chloe makes some friends there soon.
Do we have second stuff?
As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still kick her butt in PE, though.
Yeah, I don't want to hit everything twice and get repeat ones. That would be annoying. What does that say? I don't know what that post-it says. Backpack.
People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool.
And I can't skip it.
This is pretty cool.
Couldn't skip that dialogue. Mr. Sharky?
I think Chloe used to call this guy Mr. Sharky. I doubt she plays with it anymore.
She won't let us throw this out either. Watch.
You better not be thinking what I think you are.
Yep.
Chloe, I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care? If you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think that deserves an answer.
Sorry, chum.
That's better.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her. No messing with Mr. Sharky.
I want to look at everything else. I've got a height chart.
Chloe's been beating me for a while, but that growth spurt could come any day now.
Any day now. What's in here?
We bought this as a gag years ago. I honestly can't believe Chloe still has it.
What is it? Some kind of rock? Oh, drawer breaker.
What about this half-eaten jawbreaker? It's a serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be a quitter.
Oh, jeez. toss it.
Your mom and your dentist will thank me.
So lame. Just so lame.
It's like years old.
Chloe's had this hoodie for years. It's her favorite. I don't think she'd mean to throw it away.
Okay, so I can save it. Oh, she's taking it out of the trash.
What are you doing?
Your favorite hoodie. You must have thrown it in by mistake, right?
No. It's fine.
Sure.
It's filled with holes and falling apart.
That never stopped you from wearing it before.
It's fine. Really.
Okay.
I can't believe Chloe wants to part with this. Seems so unlike her.
Got stuff here. We got a lot of stuff to look at.
Chloe keeps trying to get me to hop on her board. I'd rather take pictures.
What you got? Boy band cards? Wait.
Whoa. Talk about embarrassing.
Huh. That's what it's gonna say? Shady. Mesh. Abe. Someone drew boobs on them. Can we trash those?
How about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
Sharpie boob jobs?
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
I guess these really are pieces of our past. Then again, so is this whole room.
Did I look here?
Chloe's such a nerd. She hangs on to all her old textbooks and school supplies.
Did I look at the doll head?
Live fast,
oh, yes.
Die young, and go out with a bang. Rest in pieces, doll.
I can't skip. Okay. That's it? I've seen everything. I've seen everything. Wait, I missed this. Whatever that is. Cards of stuff? Pictures? Yeah.
Ever since I started taking photos, Chloe's hung them in her room. It's like my own private gallery.
Okay. Now we can go to sleep. Or lay down. Oh, is this gonna be one of those montages where the music just plays? And I got a content
ID hit. It's so hard to believe.
ID hit.
This room, this house, this town. All in the past now. Or soon to be. Who even am I without Chloe? She's the one who's always starting things, pulling us into adventures. I can't imagine life without her. Maybe I haven't told her I'm leaving yet because I still can't believe it's real myself.
Sad. Really hard, you know, it's so close, you know. Okay. Alright, we'll talk to Chloe now. Speak.
That's it. I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Hmm.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two undersupervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later.
Oh. Oh, man. What's the right decision? Tell her later. As long as you don't wait till the last minute. I mean, when are we leaving? In a couple weeks or something? Tell her later.
The possibilities are endless. Got anything in mind?
Actually, you bet your ass I do.
Alright.
I found this when I was digging around before you got here. You're gonna flip!
I am?
Do you have any idea what this is?
727-2003. Something that's 5 or 6 years old? Pirate-related.
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever.
Sweet.
This tape is from 5 years ago. It's right. A message from our past selves to our current selves.
Oh, like a time capsule.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Like little kids.
Ready to find out?
Avast, future wayfarer! Have uncovered the audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia. Captain Bluebeard and Longneck Silver.
You were such dorks.
So, you're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
to mine eyes, but two fair pirate wenches.
What? Dad, get away! We're in the middle of an important project.
Oh, a project. Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it!
All right. Supper's in 5. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame. As I was saying,
actually, it was pretty good.
Treasure you seek, you've come to the right place. But be forewarned, the journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
Good luck. And, bye.
Who's got the amulet? Who's got the map?
Dude. That was...
Amazing.
Amazing. I can't believe you still have that.
I would never throw away something so precious. Okay. Forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting.
Sweet.
I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
What you got? Notebook?
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
Property of Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver. Keep out, Mom. For kids. For pirates. Arr. The Bane of Arcadia. Crow's Nest, Saloon, Cockpit, Galley, Treasure, Keep, and Cannons. Oh, and I forgot the plank. And there's a saloon. Where's the saloon? Oh. We can read this. Pogo the Pirate. The gang. Pogo looks like a badass there. Pirate rules. No bathing, no boys on the ship, no sharing pirate secrets. Always share plunder, always bury treasure. Always protect fellow pirates. Failure to obey these rules will result in plank walking. Mm-hmm. Captain's log. Stardate, no. Another day of plunder and destruction on the high seas. Our just buried treasure has come under attack again. The evil Commander Shelley, enemy to all pirates, has threatened to take the map from us if she sees it. Surely she has heard how valuable our treasure is and wants to steal it from us. We're doing our best to keep the map hidden as we continue to work on it. Because our enemies want our treasure so bad, we must make sure the map is only readable to us. Captain Bluebird and Long Max Silver. To more plunder and riches, Captain Bluebird and Long Max Silver. Okay.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map.
Hmm.
Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
She just said that.
There's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
Can I go to journal and stuff?
All right. Time to find this map.
I hit journal and it gives me the map thing. Hmm. Is this just look at it again? Yeah. Trying to look at this drawing.
Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class.
Oh, that's who Shelley is.
I wonder if the map is mixed in with her school supplies from that year.
Price, 516.03. Social Studies, Stars and Stripes, Chapter 11. The Civil War began when the Southern states wanted to secede from the Union. The President of the United States, Abraham Lincoln, gave the Gettysburg Address and issued the Emancipation Proclamation. The people who fought to end slavery were called abolitionists. Harriet Tubman worked with the Underground Railroad to help slaves escape to freedom. In 1864, Congress passed the 13th Amendment, a change or addition to the Constitution ending slavery. Now, supposedly these are all right, unless there's something wrong with Miss Shelley. Because she got a 100%. Great job, as always, Kelly. Now, please try to pay attention in class instead of drawing pictures with Maxine. That's Max to you, buddy. Wonder if it's in the clothes pile.
People say a lot of
things oh, same
about
thing?
The Prescott family, but
I wanted to look in the
this
knapsack.
Is pretty cool.
Book bag, whatever. What's it say? Your own story. I'm trying to see what it.
Where could that? I remember writing this. It's a story where you choose what happens.
Oh, yeah.
Wonder if I could still get to the end.
Choose your own adventure. Max and Chloe's sewer adventure.